6 months ago, I set out to implement Puzzle Time in senior living facilities, both locally and overseas. Puzzle Time is a project that involves working with seniors who have developed memory loss disorders, and my mission was to examine the short and long-term benefits of implementing cognitive activities into their routines. The jigsaw puzzles that I used as part of this project are specifically made for those who have Alzheimer's and dementia, each containing 36 relatively large pieces, which makes it easier for the residents to put them together. The plan was to visit weekly so that me and my appointed volunteers could do puzzles with the residents for around 2 hours at a time. The responses to the project initially were all very positive. The residents loved their weekly visits and really enjoyed working with each other to complete the puzzles. By the third visit, I was already seeing notable improvements in the time it took for puzzles to be solved and how the residents became more lively each time we arrived to work with them. One resident in particular named Mr. Sinclair even recognized me from previous visits. This was extremely surprising to me since Mr. Sinclair had entered his fifth stage of dementia, which is a very late and severe stage of memory loss. Knowing that the project had already proved to have a positive impact on their lives, I wanted to expand even further to serve similar communities. My family and I planned to do a trip to Brazil to visit family over the summer, and I took this as an opportunity to expand Puzzle Time. So I somehow managed to pack 18 jigsaw puzzles in a check-in bag and took a few flights to eventually arrive in the city of Salvador, which is situated on the northeast coast of Brazil. And in my opinion, although with a little bias, it's one of the most beautiful places ever. While I was there, I collaborated with two senior homes to implement Puzzle Time. Both homes were very underfunded in comparison to facilities back in the US, partially due to the lack of government focus on the growing need for elderly care. Nonetheless, both communities were extremely receptive towards the project. It was such a fulfilling and wholesome experience spending time with the residents and seeing them all work together as a team, and it honestly couldn't have went any better.
They may experience or feel some love and some, you know, affection, thinking that you are someone that's related to them, and also sometimes in a teaching moment where they're like, oh, you know, I'm gonna help this person do this. And so I think it's an amazing impact, I really do. I think people are, especially older people, they're starving for attention and they're starving for love. And I think this makes them feel worthwhile. And for a young person to truly want to share part of their self with someone else, it's pretty amazing.